In the last video, I talked about what WordPress is and about the two different versions of WordPress. If you missed that video, click on the little eye icon at the top of the screen to go back and watch it. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to the basic things that you need to create a website using the open source version of WordPress. You can find and download that version of WordPress at wordpress.org. There are three things that you need to build a WordPress website. Number one is to get the WordPress software. Number two is to set up website hosting or a place to build your website. And number three is to install a WordPress theme. Let's take a closer look at these three steps so you can really understand how this works. So the first step is getting WordPress software. You can do this by going to wordpress.org and hitting the download WordPress button. You will then have a free copy of the WordPress software that you are free to use and modify as you see fit. The other and much easier way to get WordPress software installed is to have it installed by your hosting company. And that comes up to step number two in creating a WordPress website, and that is getting website hosting or a place to build your website. WordPress is software that is designed to run on a computer server. A server is a computer that is specifically designed to share websites and other services to multiple users at the same time. Servers have specialized software installed and usually specialized hardware configurations to be able to serve up your website quickly to many people all at the same time. The easiest way to set up a WordPress website is to get a hosting company. These hosting companies have pre-configured computers all set up and ready to run websites on. Most popular hosting companies will also have an easy way to install WordPress for you. So let's take a closer look at hosting companies and what the most popular types of website hosting are. There are three main different types of website hosting. There is shared hosting, VPS or virtual private server hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. Shared hosting is usually the lowest cost hosting available, and it's a great way to inexpensively get started building a website. With shared hosting, your website lives on the same server with a bunch of other websites. Usually your website will have its own folder on the server's hard drive that only you will have access to, and of course, when it's shared to the web, that people on the web will have access to. Your website will share all the same server resources with all the other websites on that same server. Resources are things like the server computer's memory and processing power. With this kind of setup, performance of your website will depend a lot on how many other websites are on the same shared server and how many resources the other websites are taking up. The second type of hosting is VPS, or virtual private server hosting. This type of hosting uses the same server's physical hardware, but the server resources are divided up in a more precise way. Each website on a VPS will have its own installation of the operating system that the server runs on. And this is called a virtual machine. So a website with a VPS will look like it has its very own server computer, even though the physical hardware will be shared with multiple different websites. Having a virtual machine set up allows for a more precise division of the server resources, like memory and processing power. And with most VPS setups, you can add or remove memory to your virtual server as you need on the fly. Using a VPS is a great way to get more consistent results for your website. The last main type of hosting for WordPress is WordPress managed hosting. This type of hosting is usually a virtual private server that is set up and configured specifically to run WordPress websites. WordPress managed hosting will also usually include special extra features to make it easier to run and manage a WordPress website. Things like daily backups for your website, malware and hacker monitoring, as well as caching services to help your website get delivered to your viewers faster. So those are the three main types of website hosting you have to choose from. If you want to learn more about choosing a hosting company for your WordPress website, I have a video where I'll take a look at four great options for WordPress hosting and help you choose which one is right for your project. You can check that out by clicking on the eye icon at the top of the screen or by looking in the description below this video. Now, there's one other way of building a WordPress website. It's not a method that I recommend for beginners because there are more steps involved to get your website live on the internet, but it can be a good option if you want to work on your website offline on your own personal computer. Just to be clear, if you use this method, your website will not be able to be viewed on the internet. You will still need to move your website from your computer to a website hosting service before it will be live on the internet. And moving your website adds more steps, and there are more things that can possibly go wrong, which is why I don't recommend it if you're new to building websites. So for this method, you need special software to create a virtual server on your own computer. This makes your computer look like a website server so that you can install and work with WordPress right on your own machine. There are a few different options for software that you can use, and I've got a couple of tutorials that I'll link to in the description below, or again, you can look at the eye icon at the top of the screen to learn how to do this. So now we know where we can build our WordPress website. We're all set and ready to get started, right? Well, not quite. As I said before, WordPress isn't complete on its own. You need to add a theme to WordPress so that you can create web pages that your viewers will see. The theme is probably the most important part of building a website with WordPress. Choosing the right theme can give you a really easy time creating your web pages, and choosing the wrong theme can mean a lot of frustration when building a WordPress website. In the next video, we're gonna take a look at the different types of WordPress themes. So click on the link to watch the next video, or look for the link in the description below to learn more about website themes.